Hello friends, welcome to this session of Alfonsa School's e-learning classes. In this session, we are going to learn and understand about microorganisms and the kinds of microorganisms. Now friend, we are quite familiar with this term living things. Apparently, planet Earth is the only planet in the entire solar system which is made or which has life on it. Plants and animals fall into the category of living things. Now, apart from this, are there any other living things which cannot be seen by our naked eyes? Yes, there are. Trust me, friends, and these are found everywhere. They are found floating in air, floating in water, they are found moving about in the soil, they are also found in desert regions inside our body and those of other animals. So, they are found everywhere. And these are nothing but microorganisms. So, why can't we see them? Well, friends, we can see plants and animals because they are quite big in size, which can be captured by our naked eye. But in the case of microorganisms, they are pretty tiny to be captured by our naked eye. Anyways, so how can we see them? We can see them with the help of a microscope or a magnifying glass. Well, friends, so what are microorganisms then? All those tiny organisms which we cannot see by the naked eye and which can be seen with the help of a microscope or a magnifying glass are called as microorganisms. They are also called as microbes. Pretty simple, isn't it? Yes. Now, microorganisms may be unicellular, they may be multicellular. Unicellular means they are single-celled. And multicellular means they are many-celled. Now that we have understood about microorganisms, let us try and understand the kinds of microorganisms. Now, dear friends, microorganisms are categorized into five major groups: bacteria, fungi, protozoa, algae, and viruses. Let us see them in detail one by one. The first one was bacteria. Bacteria is a unicellular prokaryotic microorganism. They are also independent, at times they are parasitic. Basically, bacteria, when I say they are prokaryotic, meaning they lack in the distinct nucleus and other cell organelles. Another thing about bacteria is that they form or they come together to make a colony. Alright, now bacteria are responsible to cause many diseases also, for example, tuberculosis, typhoid, etc. Another fact about bacteria is that in given favorable conditions, they can vigorously develop or double in their number. Let's just say they can double their number in like 20 minutes. Now bacteria come in different types and shapes. For example, a rod-shaped bacteria. That is called as bacillus. A spherical or ball-shaped bacteria, that is coccus. Spiral-shaped bacteria, spirillum. And a comma-shaped bacteria, that is vibrio. So, we have understood about bacteria. Let us move to the next point, or the next kind, that is a fungi. Now, fungi are unicellular, they can also be multicellular. Friends, many times we see like a moist bread, if it is kept in the air for like 3 to 4 days and it is kept into the warm places, it gets covered with the grayish white patches. Now, if you see them under the magnifying glass, we can understand that these are like small, round, black color structures growing on the bread. That is nothing but fungus. So, what are fungus then? Fungus are actually, or they are found on the dead or decaying organic matter. They are also found on the dead bodies of plants and animals. Another fact about fungi that some are unicellular. For example, yeast. The same yeast which we use in the preparation of bread or alcohol. Some are multicellular, like many cells. For example, mushrooms, bread molds, penicillium. Now, penicillium is also used to make an antibiotic penicillin. All right, so we have quite aware with the fungi now. The next one, the next kind is protozoa. Now friends, protozoas are unicellular microorganisms. They are a little creepy because they normally feed on other microorganisms, or they are also found in the body of other microorganisms. Protozoas are also found in soil and in water. Now apart from this, protozoas are actually responsible to cause many diseases like malaria, dysentery and many more. The examples of protozoas are amoeba and paramecium. Okay, the next one now is algae. Friends, during rainy seasons we see some greenish or slippery thing in the stagnant water. That thing is nothing but algae. Now, algae are unicellular or multicellular. Basically, very few of the algae are unicellular. Most of them are multicellular. Another example of algae is Spirogyra. Now, algae are also autotrophic, meaning they make or they prepare their own food. So, this was about algae. The next one is viruses. Now, here, friends, we have seen all different kinds like bacteria, fungi, protozoa, algae. All these microorganisms are little different from that of viruses. And there is a reason for this. Well, viruses have a unique distinct feature which makes it different from rest of the kinds of microorganisms. And that is, they are only active when they are inside the cell of host organism. That is because they lack the cellular structure. When they are outside the body of the host cell, they are totally inactive or they cannot reproduce. Viruses are again little creepier because viruses are responsible to cause many diseases. Polio, swine flu, a bird flu and many more. In fact, viruses can cause many dreadful diseases like HIV/AIDS, and the recent one to which actually the world has succumbed to, that is Corona. Even that is an example of virus. So friends, here we have learned about microorganisms and their kinds. Hope you have now understood about different kinds of microorganisms. Thank you. Keep watching. Keep learning.